of my yes to you today. I choose.
Good morning. It's Thursday, the 6th of June. And if you have your Bibles, turn to 1 Corinthians 3, verse 19. 1 Corinthians 3, verse 19. I got a full cup of coffee this morning. For the wisdom of this world is foolishness in the sight of God. For it is written, He is the one who catches the wise by their craftiness. You know, many people believe that in this world we need to have power. We need to have authority. We need to be the ones who are in control. And oftentimes it's the chasing after power that becomes, our downfall. It's the trying to be on the top of the heap that drives us to not be kind to our spouses. It's that trying to get the edge over somebody else with either a little bit of our knowledge that we have over them, or a little bit of positional authority, or a bit of strength, or a bit of insight that we have that we can use to crumble them a little bit. We're constantly vying and pushing to become the most powerful person in the room, in the conversation, in the community, and we all strive to grow in our prestige and in our status and in our position and in our whatever wealth, you take it. And there seems to be that drive in the world, and that seems to be the wisdom of this world. The wisdom of this world says, become the one who is so high above the others, or at least a little above the others, that the others can't do you any harm. And make sure that you stay there. Now, that's just foolishness, because everybody's trying to climb over the next one to get to the top. And is there an ultimate position of power? Is there actually ever a place where you can reach the top and then not have someone forever trying to pull you down or get above you? So it's a constant battle where enough is never, ever actually enough. And at the end of your life, once you've reached and amassed and gained and accumulated as much as what you feel has given you status and prestige and sight in the eyes of those around you, you die, and it's not worth a cent. It's not going to count anything. What's going to count at the end of your life is the relationship that you have firstly with God, and then through God with other people. The only thing that you've invested in that you will hopefully see in eternity afterwards are those lives that you've put love, peace, joy, patience, kindness, goodness, self-control into. It's those that you've invested time. That time will be returned to you in eternity. The bank balance, the position in the company, the title in the community, none of that will count anything. So baie keer is ons gejaagd deur die wysheid van hierdie wêreld. En die wysheid van hierdie wêreld sê is, kry soveel, wees soveel as wat jy kan en bemeester en regeer. Kry die mag by mekaar. Maar eintlik aan die einde van die dag is dit verhoudings wat die verskil maak. So, dink bietjie daaroor hierdie donderdag en mag jy saam met 'n goeie vriend of vriendin 'n lekker koppie koffie vandag geniet en geniet mekaar se geselskap. Geniet Jesus in mekaar. Enjoy the Jesus in you with the Jesus in them, and grow one another and enjoy the coffee.